Have you ever questioned if the universe has a limit? We've always longed to observe space, to learn what secrets and mysteries it hides from us. We cannot, however, always do it ourselves. The only way for us to see deep space is to use a space observation station, and NASA is responsible for always doing the work for us. Today, we'll be discussing the James Webb Space Telescope. It was launched into space to provide humans with a better view of the universe. One of its missions is to capture the universe's very edge. So what could it discover? What could be lurking on the edge of the universe? What impact will it have on humanity? This adventure will be both fascinating and terrifying. So what are we waiting for? Let us all be prepared as we fly to the edge of the universe with the James Webb Space Telescope. The James Webb Space Telescope was launched into space and is currently operational. One of its amazing characteristics is that it is sensitive to infrared light, according to NASA. As a result, it can detect even the smallest amount of heat in space. Furthermore, this telescope is 100 times better than the historic Hubble telescope. It's important to note, though, that it's Hubble that has provided us with amazing images from the universe for over 3 decades. This means if James Webb is 100 times better, then it might easily surpass that record, especially considering it's designed to snap baby images of the universe. Although we can't deny that the Hubble has been really useful for us, its operation is quite limited. It can't offer scientists a glimpse of the first galaxies that formed after the Big Bang. But thanks to James Webb, we can finally see it. James Webb will record light that has traveled through space for up to 13.5 billion years. That means we could advance our knowledge of the universe hundreds of millions of years before Hubble. Isn't that fascinating? What could be the source of James Webb's immense power? The first one is its massive primary mirror, which has a diameter of 6.4 meters. It is made up of 18 smaller parts, covered in very thin gold coating, that are perfectly aligned together. Keep in mind that a 24-karat gold, which weighs less than 2 ounces, reflects infrared light better than other metals. Infrared is the light used to see things that are beyond the visible range of human vision. However, keep in mind that the mirrors are composed of beryllium rather than real gold. Another secret of the Webb telescope is that it must be kept cool in order to perform properly. And the 5-layer solar shield, which is the size of a tennis court, is the one that does the work. The sun's enormous heat would have damaged the telescope's sensors if it weren't for this shield. The side of the telescope facing the sun would be around 260 degrees Fahrenheit, while the opposite side would be roughly 370 degrees below zero, a difference of nearly 600 degrees. In short, the sun shield works like an SPF for the telescope, protecting it from the damaging sun's heat. However, one flaw of the James Webb is that it cannot be repaired when problems develop, both during launch and operation. The Hubble is capable of such feats. 5 space shuttle crews, for example, have performed routine maintenance on Hubble to rectify the telescope's initially hazy vision as well as perform repairs and upgrades. However, this is due to Hubble being only 340 miles away from Earth. The James Webb telescope is so far away, in fact, that spacewalking repair teams would be unable to reach it in the event of system failure. That means that NASA just has one chance to get it right before sending it into space. However, scientists believe that if the right technology is created, they will be able to create and send a robot to refuel Webb in the future, therefore extending its life. When it comes to power, NASA expected the telescope to last only 10 years, but because of its flawless launch, there's been enough fuel to run the James Webb for another 20 years. For the time being, scientists are patiently waiting for Webb's first photos, and after that, the telescope is believed to be of great help in studying the dark energy in the universe, and as well as help the scientists in understanding the nature of these ancient things in deep space. Furthermore, it will help humanity know if there is a possibility of another planet that can support life, among the numerous exoplanets scattered throughout the universe. It's fascinating to learn that the James Webb Space Telescope is valued at $10 billion, owing to the outstanding features it possesses. And what exactly am I referring to here? Of course, it's the telescope's mirrors and massive solar shield. Except for the James Webb's mirror creator, Northrop Grumman, no one has ever been able to manufacture a valuable mirror like that of the James Webb. Eye surgeons are now using his technology, and they've created identical software that can be installed on computers. The company has made significant progress in understanding how to launch large objects, such as how they wrap up an enormous sunshield and launch it into space. However, are you curious as to what astronomers will discover when they try to view the edge of the cosmos with the James Webb? We've long been curious about what might exist in outer space. Yet traveling across the universe involves not only moving through space, but also moving through time. Before we discuss any further, we must first consider the universe's dimension, as it is required before we can determine the universe's edge. The age of our universe is estimated to be roughly 13.772 billion years old. It is indeed pretty old. Do you want to know how big our universe really is? Its width alone is estimated to be 28.5 gigaparsecs by scientists today. But how huge is 28.5 gigaparsecs? To comprehend that number and our cosmos, we must first learn the basic concepts of astronomical units. An astronomical unit, or AU, is the average distance between the Sun and the Earth, which is around 150 million kilometers. Aside from AU, we need to figure out what a parsec is and how big it is. A parsec is the longest length of a triangle whose shortest side is 1 AU, and the opposite vertex subtends an angle of 1 arc second. If you do the math, 1 parsec is 3.26 light years, or the distance traveled by light in a year, which is approximately 9 trillion 460 billion kilometers. Let us go back to the topic of the vastness of the universe, which is estimated to be 28.5 gigaparsecs. Taking into account computation, it would be 93 billion light years, or 879,780 times 10 raised to the power of 18 kilometers. To say the least, that is quite enormous. Before we continue, I just want to remind you that if you made it this far into the video, you're clearly enjoying it. Give it a like, subscribe so you don't miss anything, and let us know what you think in the comments section. I'd like you to take a close look at the figures I mentioned previously. Is there anything that might seem off? That might be the speed of light and the universe's size. We are all aware that the speed of light is the absolute highest speed that can be achieved. That means if the universe is 13.7 billion years old, how does it have a width of 93 billion light years? It is important to note that if an object generated shortly after the Big Bang moved at a speed of light, it should have traveled no more than 13.7 billion light years by now. Where did all the matter beyond this point come from? This is when Hubble's law comes into play. According to the Hubble's law, things detected in distant space are redshifted. The term redshift refers to the change in wavelength, usually an increase of light toward the end of the spectrum. But why does the wavelength lengthen? One reason for this is the universe is expanding. Yes, this is not just about the fact that only objects move apart from one another, but space itself is growing as well. What is even more shocking is that the expansion is speeding up. This is why, when calculating the width of the universe, the distance due to space expansion must be taken into account. Dark matter and dark energy are thought to play a significant role in this event. However, it is safe to say that the universe's edge is clearly not 13 billion light years away from the Earth, but significantly higher than that. Despite all of this, I am certain of one thing. We will never see objects in the universe that are particularly beyond 16 billion light years away from Earth. Yes, we can assume that this is also the universe's edge. Have we reached it? Well, not yet. In addition, this is the maximum distance at which light could ever reach us. This means that beyond the edge of the universe, which is 16 billion light years, the spread of space is faster than the speed of light. In that case, the light will obviously never reach us, since it has to travel across an increasing space. This also means that any event which occurs beyond the edge mark will forever be unknown to humanity. But because of telescopes like the James Webb Space Telescope, this game has changed. The GNZ-11 galaxy, which is around 32 billion light-years away from Earth, is the most distant galaxy ever discovered by James Webb. We reach what is known as the surface of last scattering, roughly 46 billion light-years away from Earth. The surface of last scattering is the thing that we will see regardless of whatever way you look. After recombination and photon decoupling, the first ever photons of cosmic microwave background radiation emerge from the surface of last scattering, which appears to be a homogeneous sphere of fog. It is the genesis of the very first scattering of light. Does this mean that the surface of last scattering is the ultimate destination of the universe? Well, the answer is both yes and no. Since this is the furthest point in space and time that humans can witness, then it could be called the edge of the observable universe. What we don't know beyond this universe is called the opaque universe. This also marks the limit of what humanity can witness, but is still free to imagine. What do you think lies beyond the observable universe? So far, what we've discovered is what existed at a certain place in space in the distant past. A more bizarre question is, what could possibly have happened right there, right now? The particle horizon, or the farthest distance one can view into the past, is located at the edge of the observable universe. Everything we've seen thus far has been done so with Earth at the center and time scaled backwards with distance. This raises the question of whether the cosmos is limitless. According to Einstein's theory of relativity, a flat world must be endless. Can we thus conclude that the universe has no beginning or end? We can't answer that yet, since we haven't been able to definitively determine what lies in the observable universe and beyond it. So, what are your thoughts? What do you think about the universe's edge? Let us know in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Please click the bell icon so you'll be notified when new videos are posted. And as always, thanks for watching Ponder This.